Alrighty, so welcome to Pilates Wind Down. Let's all come on up, take your feet about hip width and parallel. I'm Marianne, if you don't know me, and also for those of you on YouTube, I'm also doing a Zoom class. So if I keep looking down and up, it's because I have two cameras, okay? All right, so with that said, relax your shoulders, take your hands to your thighs, and then just slide the hands down. And from here, I just want you to take your hands to your shins and bend straight in those legs. Just alternate bending your knees for me. Stay in a nice fold over. Just let the back of your thighs, back of your legs start to open up. Start my playlist from the beginning. Just keep alternate bending. Bend, bend, bend. All right, now do me a favor. Grab behind both calves and then bend your knees and straighten. Just use a little pressure here with the hands, push into the calves. Bend, straighten. Remember the head should go straight down. Bend, straighten. One more time. And then if you need to keep a little bend in those knees, go ahead. Just let the hands dangle straight down. And then just twist right and left. I've got my hands interlaced. Up to you guys, you can keep them straight down. If they're interlaced, just let them go side by side. I want you to twist over to the right, grab outside the right leg. Hopefully you're gonna start to feel that IT band stretch on the outside of the leg. Then just make a little half circle to get over to the left, grab outside that leg. And then half circle back to the right. Take it back to the left. And then just take it center. Bend your knees, come up nice and slow. Head, neck, and shoulders come out last. Take a big inhale up with those arms. Grab your left wrist. On your exhale, just bend to the right. Draw the left shoulder back, hold the belly in. Now from here, I want you to just take a little rotation, send the left shoulder back, and then gaze to the ceiling. Little twist in the left side. Breathe. And then come on back to center. Inhale the arms up. On the exhale, grab that right wrist. Take a bend to the left. Open the chest towards the ceiling. Keep that side bent. Hold that belly in. And then take it back to center. Interlace your hands behind you. Draw back. Just do a little back bend. Let the head dangle back down. And then come on up. Okay, hi Jules, we're gonna take it down to the mat. I forgot to tell you guys, sorry. So tonight I'm gonna use a ball and one weight, and I have a 2-pound weight. So if you wanna take a second and grab your stuff, go ahead and grab it. We're gonna come to all fours when you guys are ready. Take your hands right underneath your shoulders. From here, I want you to just let your shoulder blades drop down towards the mat and then press them back up. Let them drop down, take them back up, down, take them up. Now hold them in place, curl your toes under, take a breath in. On the exhale, hover your knees above the mat. Hold strong, guys. Don't let the shoulder blades sink back down. Release the knees to the mat, find a neutral spine. Push the shoulders back up into place, take an inhale, exhale, hover those knees. One more time, knees go down, round the shoulders, up into the back. Crawl the toes under, hover those knees up. And then the knees come down, right foot comes up. So bring the toes up off the mat, rotate to the right. The right leg goes to the right as you look at it. Now rotate the right leg all the way to the left as you look over the left shoulder. Take it back to the right, look over the right shoulder. Called wag the tail. Take it to the left. Take it to the right. And then you're going to set it back down. Left foot lifts up. You're going to rotate it to the right as you look over the right shoulder at your toes. Take it to the left. Look over the left shoulder. Back to the right. Left, rotating from the waist. up those abs. And then you're gonna release it down, push it back to a child's pose. Toes together, knees need to be as wide as you need them. Just sway it right and left. And then walk your hands towards you. Slowly bring your head, neck, and shoulders on up. You're gonna grab your wait, I'm gonna turn a light on because I feel like it's getting dark in here. You can still see me, right, you guys? Can everyone still see me okay? Yes, thumbs up. Yeah. Okay, thanks. All right, so grab a weight if you have it. You're gonna come on down to your mat. Don't worry if you don't have the weight, okay? So I want your legs to be about 3/4 bent here. I'm flexing my feet so my heels are digging into the mat. Start with a straight spine. We're gonna do some C-curve work. We're gonna start with a straight spine. Just practice and work on the breathing. So if you have a weight, take it out. If you don't have the weight, don't worry. Just take an inhale, lift the arms up. Inhale through your nose, then sharply exhale back out. Inhale up, pull that belly in, exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down. Take it up, now from here, scoop it back to your C-curve, and then bring it up. Inhale, take it up, scoop back, exhale, straighten that spine. Inhale through your nose, scoop back. Exhale through your mouth. So you have to use that breath, you guys. It's really gonna engage your abs. I know I tell you that all the time. Take it up, scoop it back, hold that belly in nice and tight. Now hold back for me. Gonna row it to the right, take it left. So important, peek at your knees. There's gonna be some movement, but you want to not have a ton of movement. Well, good evening, Margaret, hello. Dip it right, dip it left. Hi all you guys who signed on after I started. Welcome. Rotate, guys. Can you come back one more inch? Really flex those feet for me. Keep rowing. Do you feel like we're in a kayak, but we're not really going anywhere? Row, row. All right, you guys, take it back center. Can you come back any farther in your C curve? Relax your shoulders, hold here. Hollow this out, belly in. Now just come out of it a little bit, back to where you were, then take it farther, hold. Dig those heels in the mat. Come on up, hold, you're still in your C curve, so you're not straight spine, take it back. Bring it up. Exhale, take it back, hold. Take another breath in, bring it up, bring it back. Carve out that belly, you guys, bring it up. Bring it back, hold back, walk your feet towards you, bring it all the way back down to your spine. Take your weight in your hands, bring it behind your head. And rest your head on it. Not super comfy, but not too bad. Now take those legs back to about 3/4 bend here. Dig the heels into the mat. Take the elbows to the ceiling. We're gonna 2 count up, exhale, crunch it up, up, inhale, back down. Exhale, bring it up, up. Inhale, back down. Up, up, back down. Abs are doing the work, you guys, okay? Use that breath, sharp exhales, up, up, inhale down. Up, up, head, neck, and shoulders lift. Up, up, down. Breathe, breathe. Down, on this next one, hold up for me. Open the elbows, little crunches, up, up. Flex those feet again. Up, elbows wide, head resting on that weight. Crunch, crunch. Get those shoulder blades to clear the mat, you guys. You got it. Up, up. Find that crunch for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it up on one. Hold, hold, hold. And then release the weight. Bring yourselves on up. How we doing? I'll take that as an excellent. No, all good. All right. We're going to do So I'm gonna do some more ab work on our forearms. We're gonna transition to like a modified teaser, okay? You're gonna like it, I promise. So come on down your forearms to start. Elbows under the shoulders. Lift that chest up and open for me, okay? So you're gonna draw your legs out. And then from here, you're gonna lower. Circle, I gotta move my water bottle. Lower, circle, lower, circle. Just keep lifting that chest up and open, you guys, you got it. Lower, circle. Hold that belly in, use that breath. Exhale as you lower, inhale as you circle. Two more. Don't worry how straight the legs are, okay? All right, we're gonna switch it up a bit, so hold here. So your left leg's gonna be your leader for a little bit, so keep the left leg up, lower the right leg. Now you're gonna windmill those legs opposite direction, right's on top, scissor switch one time, left is back on top. Windmill, scissor switch, windmill. We wanted that left leg to be leading. One more time. Now hold here. This time, left leg is still leading, okay? Windmill. Now take the legs together. Push up off of those elbows to a modified teaser. Excellent, you guys. Bring it back down to the forearms. Left leg still leading. Circle. Get them together. Lift up to teaser. Two more times, guys. Bring it down. Left leg up. Windmill. Together. Up. Bring it back down. Left leg up last time. Bring it up. All right, put those feet down. Open the chest first, do a little back bend. We're gonna take it to the right side. Legs go back up, right's our leader this time. Just start with the windmills. Scissor switch right back up. Exhale, inhale, exhale. One more time before we add teaser, okay? Here we go. Windmill, legs together, push it up the teaser. Stay on those hands. Perfect, bring it back down. Right leg up, left leg down, windmill. Get those legs back together, bring it up. Bring it back down, right leg up, left is down, windmill. Bring them together, push it up. One more time, right. Use that breath, you guys. Perfect, bring your feet back down. Scoot the chest to the ceiling. Little back bend. One more round with these guys. Draw your knees to your chest, legs to ceiling, lower. You're back on your forearms. Exhale, lower those legs. Inhale, knees to chest, legs to ceiling, lower. Don't worry if they are not super straight, guys. You guys are awesome. All right, ready to add the V? Knees to chest, legs to ceiling. Lift up off of those elbows to a V. Bring it back down. Knee to chest, leg to ceiling, lower. Knees come in, up V. Perfect, back down. Lower those legs, knees to chest. Legs to ceiling, push it up. Let's feel on this. Ready, legs down, knees in, legs up, lift up. One more time, guys, I promise. Legs up, lower, knees in, legs up, scoot it up. Bring it all the way up. Take the soles of those feet together. Nice job. Butterfly those legs, rounded power. Come on, that was kind of fun, wasn't it? Sharon Miller saying no, I can see that. All right, so you guys, we're gonna take it to our mats. Or no, well, we're already on our mats. No, we're gonna take it to all fours. If you have the ball, pop it between your thighs. If you have a yoga block, you can do that. You can use a towel, or you don't need anything. Wrists under those shoulders. Knees under those hips. Curl your toes under. We did this in the warm-up, so take a breath. I was gonna say hold your breath. Take a breath, hover your knees. From here, shoulder blades go back up towards the ceiling. Now, twist from the hips, twist, twist, twist. Gaze to the top edge of the mat for me, guys, or to your fingertips, okay? Rotate those hips, twist, twist. Hold that belly in super tight, guys. Twist it, twist, twist, twist. Hold it center. Right heel kicks up, lower your knees, lift, left up, lower, lift, right up. I'm not touch the ground, guys. Take it down, take it up. Heel kick, down, up. Heel kick, knees hover, they're back up. Heel kick, hover. Hold right here, knees down, knees up, knees down. Don't let them touch the mat. Hold that belly in, take them down, take them up, take them down, take them up for four, three, two. Last one, bring them all the way down. Get rid of that ball. All right, we are gonna stay on all fours. I just need to move a little bit. Also, my dog's in my way, but we'll see what happens. Okay, so back to that all fours position, wrist on your shoulder, step back with that right foot, lift it lower, take it up, take it down. Practicing not letting those shoulder blades sink into your back, so you've got to push yourself away from the mat. Take it up, take it down, squeeze that butt cheek. Up and down for four, three, two. Straight leg, wag the tail, hold it up. Rotate that leg to the right. Look at it. Rotate it to the left. Rotate it to the right. Maybe it doesn't stay up to hip height. Your gaze follows those toes side to side, guys. Two more. Take that leg all the way to the right, set it down, flex it. From here, push yourselves back, sit on your left heel. Get that inner thigh stretch. Keep the right foot flexed, bring it back up. Sit back. Bring it up. Sit back. Second to last thing on this side. Two more times. Hold up for me, guys. Take your left hand, just set it on the mat right outside of your left knee. From here, you're gonna lift left hand, right leg up, down. You're not going that high with that right foot leg, right? Keep the foot flexed. Gaze the top edge of the mat for me, guys. Up, up, up for four, three, two. Last one, come on back to center, cat-cow with me, round your spine. Arch and gaze ahead, round. Arch and gaze ahead, round. Arch, find a neutral spine, step back with that left leg, point those toes, lift it and lower. Take it up, take it down. Try to find that right hip over that right knee, you guys, up and down. Find your fingertips, find the top edge of your mat. Resist tucking your chin to your chest. Up, up. That butt, that hamstring's doing the lifting here. Straight leg up. Four more. Three, two. Keep pressing yourself away from the mat. Hold it up, guys, rotate that. Leg to the right, to the left. Take it to the right. Take it to the left. Take it to the right. Left, your gaze is following it. Maybe that leg is not up super high tonight. You'll get there. Rotating from the waist. Two more times. Great job. Hold it to the left, set it down, flex the foot, sit back. And then bring it up. And then sit back, get that inner thigh stretch. It's all about opening up and flexibility. Back. Take it up. Inhale back. Exhale up. Hold up. Take the right hand outside of the mat in line with the right knee and then lift and lower opposite arm and leg to the side. Up, up. for four, three, two. Last one. We should be nice and warmed up for pretzel. Sit it back to a child's pose. Sway it right and left. All right, gang. If you have a Pilates ball, grab it. If you don't and you want to put a little towel behind your knee for pretzel, you can use that as well. Here's the way we're going to set up. So we're going to take our left shin in line with the front of the mat. Okay, come straight out, left knee comes straight out from the right hip. Then scoot the right leg back, same thing. The right knee comes back, is right knee is in line with the hip, take the ball behind the knee. From here, you're gonna pitch yourself over your left knee. We're gonna do a push-up as we lift and lower that back leg. So try to scoot your leg back, you guys, so it goes beyond your hip even slightly, okay? The right one, take it up. Take it down. Getting some upper body in as well. For four, scoot that leg back there. Three, two, hold it up on one, guys. Take it up an inch, press back an inch. Up, back, lift it up, push back, up. You're still pitched over your left knee, sorry. Take it up. Take it back, lift, back, up, back. Gonna get those hips to open up. We're working that whole side body. Last time, take it up, take it back. Just push it back, back. So maybe that knee isn't up super high. Maybe the knee is on the ground and you're just sliding it back. That's okay, you guys. Do the best you can. Back, back, back. Back. All right, hold it back. Grab the ball. Extend the leg as you rotate to the left. Bring it back. Replace it. Push the leg back. Grab the ball. Extend and rotate to the left. Ball goes back. Push the leg behind you. Extend and rotate. Back. Push. Get that rotation. Reach that ball. Maybe you don't have the ball, you just reach in your arms. Two more, guys. Don't hold that breath. Don't find yourself holding it. Hold that ball right there. Pulse it up, 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 up. Maybe you can bring your spine upright a little more. Maybe not. Last eight, seven, six. Push that knee back there. Four, three, two. Last one. Grab onto that leg. Give it a little love. Hook your elbow in that crevice of that knee. Rock it back and forth. Ouchie, right? All right, right knee comes right out from the hip. Slide the left one back. Take the ball behind that left knee. And from here, pitch yourself over that right knee. Push up, leg comes up and down. Lift, lower, crunching into that left waistline. Down and up. Scoot that knee way back there, you guys. Nice job, gang. Down and up. Down and up. Such a fun way to do push-ups. Down and up. Keep that knee back there. Hold the leg up. Take it up. Push back. Up. Back. Up. Back. So how high your knee is dependent on your flexibility, right? And your strength. Lots of factors play a role with getting that knee up off the mat. Up, core strength, up, back. Lift an inch, back an inch. Up, back, up, back, up, back. Just push it back, back. Maybe you challenge yourself. Try to get that knee up higher. Push, push. Hold that core tight. Hold that belly in, you guys. Back, back. All right, ready? Grab the ball. Extend the leg as you rotate to the right. Replace the ball. Push the foot back. Grab it, extend. I lost my ball. Push. Extend and rotate. Push. Extend and rotate. Push. Breathe for me. Use that breath. Don't hold it. Two more, guys. There you go. Replace that ball. Pulse it up. 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 So the more you lean to the side, the more you're going to be able to get that leg up, the easier it's going to be. So be where you need to be. Up. Carve out this waistline right here. That's 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Last one. Get rid of that ball. Give that leg a little love. All right. We're going to do some spinal extensions, you guys. So come on down to your bellies for me. All right, take your legs wide. Take your hands and you're gonna reach behind and your palms are gonna be up. So from here, pull your belly in. You'll feel your pelvic bone go right into the mat when you do that. You're gonna lift just the upper body, guys. Lift it and then lower. Lift, lower, take it up. As you lift, gang, pull your belly in, okay? Take it up, down, up, down. Up, down, one more. Hold up, push the tops of your feet into the mat. And then bring your hands in front of you, rest hand over hand, rest your forehead down. Pull that belly in, leave your hands right where they are. I want you to lift the chest up. And then bring it back down. So take your nose, just like you're rolling a marble, to the top edge of the mat, okay? That's how you peel the upper body up. Go to the point that you can, you guys. Here we go, one more time. Now, leave your head on the, leave your forehead on the hands. Lift the hands up, and then lower. Hands come up with that upper body, you guys. Lower. Pull that belly in. Lower. This time, lift. Extend the arms back behind you. Interlace the fingers. Lift up higher. Lower body stays down. Replace the hands down, replace the forehead down, lift everything. Extend the hands back, interlace the fingers, draw back. Feet still stay down. Hands back down, head back down, upper body only, lift up. Extend the hands behind, interlace the fingers, draw back. And then release back down. You guys got it, push it back to a child's pose. Big toes together, knees go wide, slide those hands away from you, sway it right and left. All right, you guys have made it to the stretch portion of our Pilates wind down class, so great job. So find yourself in a seated position. We're gonna start with the back and the shoulders. So I'm gonna take what I consider to be my non-dominant leg, so that's my left, and I'm gonna put that in front, okay? So find whichever one is your less strong leg or less flexible and put it right in front. We're just gonna start by cat-cowing, so take your hands to your knees and then scoop out that belly round your spine. And then you're gonna arch and gaze ahead. And then round. Arch and gaze ahead. Round. We're gonna try to hold each stretch a little longer than normally, and really get into those ligaments and those muscles. Straighten, exhale round. Exhale, straighten, round. Straighten, round. All right, hold into a neutral spine. Take an inhale up with your arms, you guys. On your exhale, rotate to the right. Take that twist, so the right hand goes behind you, relax your shoulder down, and then just stay in the rotated position. Hold your belly in. So rotations are so good for your digestive system, you guys. So Think about that. All the rotating we do in bar and Pilates is awesome. Just relax that shoulder. Try to rotate a little bit deeper to the right. So find yourself resistant to let the shoulders let go. Stay rotated. I probably should have mentioned to you guys to make sure you're on mute during the class, and I forgot to say that, so I apologize. Take a rotation again. So keep your left hand outside of the right thigh. Keep yourself rotated. Extend your right arm up with an inhale. On the exhale, I want you to side bend, but I want you to resist by pulling on that right leg. Draw the right shoulder back. We are still rotated to the right, you guys. Take a breath in. On the exhale, maybe you can side bend a little bit more, find a little more opening in that right side. Another breath in. Exhale it out. Rotate again, guys. And then side bend a little bit deeper. Try to find a little more space in your body with every breath. And then you're gonna bring that hand down. You're gonna come back to center with your spine. Take an inhale out. Right arm goes on top. You guys, we're gonna go into eagle arms. So cross over. If you can't get to this position, I get it. Just take prayer hands together, okay? But right arm should be on top because we were rotating to the right, right? So lift and lower. Lift, lower. I know this can be intense, this stretch. So if you can't get there, just do the prayer hands up and down. Lift, lower. Sit up nice and tall, breathing, guys. Last one, just release it out, shake out those arms, take a breath in as the arms sweep up, rotate to the left for me. Sit up nice and tall, relax that shoulder behind you, just wrap the hand around, take the right hand, grab outside of the left thigh. Keep that nice strong twist in the lower body. Belly is in. Also a great twist do after you eat too much, okay? As we were talking about digestion. Rotate. Breathe. Sit up tall. Resist those shoulders hiking up, you guys. Rotate one more inch to the left. Inhale that left arm up. Exhale, side bend. So this is where you're pulling and using your pressure here outside of that right leg, left leg, sorry. Keep that left shoulder back, bend a little deeper. Use your breath to continue to find an opening in the left side body. So take an inhale, exhale it out. If it bugs your neck, just keep the gaze down, okay? Inhale again, exhale, bend a little deeper. Lift up towards the ceiling, then bend deeper. Pull on the outside of that left leg. Take it back to center. Take an inhale out with those arms. Left goes on top as you wrap those arms at the elbows. Try to get those hands to prayer and then lift and lower. Again, your alternative is just taking your forearms together and lift and lower, okay? Up and down. Sit up tall. Lengthen that spine. Beautiful job, you guys. A few more. All right, inhale those arms out. On the exhale, you're gonna clasp your hands behind your head. We're gonna work on that neck. So you're gonna draw your elbows together as you round forward, push the head into the hands. Inhale, bring the elbows back, straighten your spine. Exhale, round. Up. Use the pressure of your head, push it into your hands.
down.
Up. Down. Getting into the thoracic spine to the upper part of that back. I like to say the mid-upper. Two more, guys. Last one. Bring it up. Gently switch the cross of those legs for me. Take an inhale out with those arms. On the exhale, clasp the hands behind you. Just going to draw it down and do that little baby back bend. Breathe. Bring it back to neutral. Keep your hands clasped behind you. Draw them over to the right hip. Now take your right ear to your right shoulder and just hold. But keep a nice straight, tall spine, okay? Ear to shoulder. Keep that left shoulder back. Get that stretch on the side of the left neck. Breathe. Inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. And then take it back, back bend again. Draw the hands away from you. Draw the hands back in. Take them over to the left hip. And then left ear, left shoulder. Try to set them outside of that hip. Little traction here. Draw the right shoulder back, you guys. Breathe into the right side of the neck. Sit up tall. Take another breath in. Exhale it out. Take it back. Take your hands back behind you onto the floor. Walk them back. Back bend again. Open that chest. And then take those hands. You're going to bow over to the right, to the left, to the right, left. Take your hands to your knees. Right shoulder goes towards left knee. Come back up. Left shoulder, right. Up. Just try to take that opposite shoulder down. All right, you guys. Bring it on over to all fours for me. You're going to curl your toes under. You're going to scoot that butt up towards the ceiling. You're going to pedal out your feet. Walking the dog in your down dog position, nice straight arms, nice long body, ears by your biceps. We're gonna work on our quads and our hamstrings a little bit here. Inner thighs too, hips. Bring it forward. Right knee comes down, step forward to the left. You're gonna find a nice long lunge here. Slide the right hip, right leg back, right hip goes down. Try to have that spine nice and straight. Maybe your hands stay right here. Maybe you want to bring them down here. Just try to keep a long spine for me. Right hip going down. Breathe. Get those hips open up. Think about pushing your right hip forward, your left hip back. And then scoot your hips back, find a hamstring stretch. So right knees right under that right hip, flex the left foot, square your hips again, push the right hip forward, pull the left back. Maybe you can reach those toes, you want to flex them a little more to get a deeper stretch. Breathe. Send that breath to the back of that left leg. Come back into that nice long lunge. Wiggle your left foot wider than the mat. Let it tip open. Slide the right leg back just a little bit farther. Maybe you can take those elbows down to the mat. Maybe you stay up on those hands. Depends where your flexibility is tonight. Breathe. One more breath. Heel toe that foot back in line with the hip. You're going to crawl the right toes under, step back with the left. Take it back to that down dog position.
Use your finger pads, the heels of your hands into the mat. Walk those feet up. When you're ready, bring that body weight forward. Release the left knee down. The right foot steps forward. Find that long lunge. Walk your hands up to that left right thigh. Scoot that left hip down. Square those hips for me, gang. Left hip forward, right hip back. You can lean the body forward to get a little deeper stretch. Just don't round. Try to not be on that kneecap, okay? So I need you to be above the knee. Take another breath in. On your exhale, you're gonna shift those hips back, straighten that right leg, align the left knee right under the hip, flexing that right foot. Maybe you grab those toes, give a little love here. Square your hips for me again, right hip back, left forward. Breath, open up the back of that right leg. One more breath in. Exhale it out. Shift it back to that lunge. Walk the foot wider than the mat. Let it tip open. Come off of that left knee. Encourage the hip down. Maybe you're down to those forearms. Maybe you're staying right up here. You're tightening up and loosen. Is your jaw clenching? Are your teeth clenching? Use your breath. Inhale. Exhale out. Walk that foot back in line. Then you're going to take it behind you. Come on down. Take your elbows right underneath your shoulders. Spread your fingers wide. And then just lift that gaze up. Belly's in. Bring it back down with an inhale. Exhale, open up the front and the back. Down again. Last time, guys, bring it up. Find a neutral spine. Big toes together. Knees go wide. Push it back to child's pose. Reach back. Grab your heels for you. Curl yourself into a little ball. Breathe. Sway right and left. Slowly peel that body up. You can just sit on your knees for a minute. Take a breath in, sweep those arms up. You're gonna come back to the sides two more times as our Pilates wind down class tonight. Take it up. All right, you guys, last time. You grab all that energy, take it up. Grab it in your hands, release it at heart center. Take that energy with you. I love you guys. All right, let me do my little thing up here.